Good Saturday morning, everybody, live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee. I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. If you've never tuned in here before, thanks for joining us for the first time. We are live on Periscope and Twitter and making certain that you know a little bit more about what's going on with the weather and to multiple platforms for this morning. So we're also going to be going live on our Facebook page here in just a little bit. Assuming that all of that works, everything should be, again, looking pretty good into the rest of the day today. So if you have any plans for outdoors, if you've got, again, anything outdoors for, again, the rest of the day, especially this afternoon, you are going to have to, again, see the possibility of getting back indoors again, maybe to cool yourself off by just a little bit, as we see, again, the possibility of some showers out there across the Mid-South. Nothing huge, nothing severe right now, but later on today, that could be a much different story, so stay tuned for more on that. Let's go ahead and take a look and see what's going on outside from our Germantown City Hall cam. Welcome to all of our viewers on Facebook for this morning who are just joining us. Your complete forecast, again, in the blue bar here. Social media here, also up there. Don't forget to check out our webpage at WREG.com/webcams. Rest of the area today, again, plenty of clouds moving their way on through, according to what we see on the City Hall cam. We also have, again, some scattered light showers taking place into and around the area of eastern Arkansas. Back around Jonesboro, moving through parts of Craighead County. We have some scattered light showers going on here, moving to the northeast at about maybe 20 to 30 miles per hour. More scattered showers heading up from I-40 in central Arkansas, just about ready to move into western parts of Cross County in Arkansas, and Poinsett County also seeing some scattered showers there. Heaviest activity by far crossing over Forest City, I-40 around Crowley's Ridge, making its way to the northeast into northeastern parts of St. Francis County, and then some more light scattered shower activity into and around the area, close to around portions of back into northwestern Mississippi, east of Horseshoe Lake and west of Lynchburg, Walls, and Horn Lake. Some scattered light showers going on there. Beyond that, there's little, if anything, going on in West Tennessee so far this morning. I'm going to continue again to see the potential for more of these scattered showers across parts of the Mid-South throughout the rest of the day. Not everybody's going to be picking them up, and keep in mind that a lot of what we're going to be seeing today is going to, again, be so light and so dry down toward the surface that we are going to see, again, some of this activity evaporating on its way on down. So we could see, again, the possibility of some rumbles of thunder. Most of what we're looking at for right now is just light rainfall, and that's going to be about the main threat that we see out of any of this for later on today. So if you have any plans for outdoors, this is what you're mainly going to be looking for. Also, again, can't rule out the possibility of some thunderstorms mixed in with this as we do go throughout the rest of the day today. That could, again, be something of a concern as we get into the rest of the morning for later on into this afternoon. So if we have any potential problems out there, again, that's going to be the main threat today. We will be looking for more potential of problems as we go throughout the rest of the weekend. We'll talk more about that coming up here in just a little while. Currently live on Periscope. Thanks for tuning in if you are on Periscope for this morning, and looking again at numbers back into around the lower to mid 70s for temperatures a little bit later on today. Typhoon Lan is the big thing. That's L-A-N. Typhoon Lan is making its way north of the Philippines and heading toward areas close to Japan. This is a monster storm. Typhoon has a 50-mile-wide eye, and over the next several days, this thing is going to be visiting Japan, heading up to the north and to the east. This thing has got a lot of energy to it. It's going to be moving up close to around the area of eastern Japan. But then over the next several days, as this thing gets a little bit closer to the jet stream, which you can see in the dark red and purple categories up here, it's going to be kind of like snapping a whip or snapping a rope in gym class or a hose outdoor in the yard. When you snap that, the wave of energy travels along, and this thing, this storm system on the other side of the planet, for all intents and purposes, is going to be sending a wave of energy into the jet stream, and that's going to be doing a very good job of causing cooler weather to come down from parts of the Arctic area. And that's going to do, again, a great job of keeping things much cooler here in the Mid-South That's what that means. Again, this is what we're going to be seeing into the area for right now. So Matt Walls on Facebook, that's what we're talking about right now. The typhoon that's going to be hitting Japan later on is going to be dropping our temperatures quite nicely, all thanks to this change in temperatures coming our direction pretty soon. This information from the Meteorological Center in Tokyo. You can get more information about the tropics by going to the National Hurricane Center. That's at hurricanes.gov, and they have connections to a lot of different places if you'd like to learn more about what's going on well over into the Pacific and more information about how that can affect us. No earthquakes to report this morning as opposed to last Sunday where we had a 3.6 earthquake occur. Everything has been quiet for the most part since then. Nothing else showing up at this time. More of our WeatherBug cameras at WREG.com/webcams if you'd like to see more about what it looks like across the Mid-South there. Radar is showing again a few of those light scattered sprinkles showing up. Just light activity across Arkansas. Some of that wandering into parts of northwest areas of Mississippi. Beyond that, not much going on. You can check out more with our radar page, our interactive radar page at WREG.com/weather, and then click on the weather section for more information about it, and tons of information on here from lightning strikes to earthquakes and all that information all available from there. So staying tuned for more on that. Good morning to Sam Reichard from Olive Branch, former mayor and current meteorologist. Thanks for joining us. Mark Lewis Levine, thanks for joining us on Facebook this morning. Brett Smith, Gladys Clark, Gloria Davis, Emma Boozer from Barton, Mississippi. Thank you very much for tuning in. Let's take a look and see what's going on. New storm system on the way. And as this moves our direction, better chances of rainfall, help to settle the dust, reduce our fire conditions out there, so that's good news. Could be some severe weather west of us. We'll talk about that coming up in just a little while. Rest of the day today, tonight especially, we could be looking for the possibility of some strong thunderstorms late tonight, early tomorrow morning. Borderline severe, doesn't look like a great chance, but again, something we need to pay attention to. And then east central Arkansas and north central Mississippi as we go into Sunday. So again, that could be a bit of a concern there. Wednesday morning could be some frost in parts of the Tennessee River Valley as some much cooler air makes its way on through. High temperatures today will be back into around the lower 80s to the mid to upper 70s, so some very warm conditions out across much of the Mid-South. Low temperatures tonight in the high 60s to the lower 70s. Highs on Sunday with more chances of rainfall overspreading the entire Mid-South area, going up to about 90% plus possibility of rain, cooling things off mid-70s for high temperatures there. And then a little bit cooler on Monday as well, mid to upper 60s with a good chance of rain and thunderstorms throughout the entire Mid-South out there. Mark Lewis Levine, well, rainfall, that could be a bit of a problem out there. Your Halloween decorations are going to get pretty soaked from what it looks like out across the Mid-South, so you may want to think about bringing those in if at all possible. Highs on Tuesday back in the mid-60s. Highs on Wednesday in the lower 60s. That's the high temperatures, upper 50s to lower 60s. But we have to wait until later next weekend, which is just beyond the range of this particular forecast from the National Weather Service. This is where we start to see, again, the much cooler weather heading our way. Severe weather at this time, the main threat is going to be, again, into the plain states. Not for us. We're going to be seeing the possibility in that light green shaded area of some thunderstorms, yes, but the best possibility of severe weather will be back from southwest Missouri into north central Texas, most of Oklahoma, parts of southwest Kansas, and a very small part of northwest Arkansas. That enhanced risk will be the best possibility of seeing severe weather into the rest of the day. So this could be a bit of a problem for outdoor activities there and for travel. If you're heading toward I-40 west later on today, you could be running into some pretty strong thunderstorms there. Julia Cavallo, thanks for stopping by and thanks for the kind words on that. Possibility of severe weather in the Mid-South is not going to be that much of a problem for us. We will be looking again at the threat of just isolated thunderstorms. That green area that you see is just generic thunderstorm risk. Not expecting severe weather, but one or two of those could be strong to borderline severe, and we will be watching that. The main threat is going to be from the possibility of heavy rainfall across the Mid-South, so we'll be watching that very carefully as well. Tune in for more with my Facebook page. If you haven't been there before and you're tuning in on Twitter and Periscope this morning, it's www.facebook.com/AustenOnek, WREG, and also on Twitter if you're on Facebook and would like to join me on Twitter. More information available at twitter.com/AONIC_WREG3, and would love to have you along for the ride. And if you got pictures from the Mid-South, sunrise, sunset, anything like that, tune in. We'd love to have that. Also available at WREG.com, our full seven-day forecast, and that's available at WREG.com/weather. I got to hop out on set to get things ready for our 8:15 weather broadcast on Daybreak. Nina Harrelson on the set with news. Glenn Carver's got an update on all the morning sports from last night on Friday Night Football. More of my forecast available throughout the weekend on Country 92.5 and Oldies 102.3, so tune in for that if you can't tune in on TV or watch on the computer. And, of course, more available at WREG.com/weather. More details on your forecast throughout the rest of the weekend on air and online with News Channel 3, so stay tuned for more on that. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Thanks for joining us for our Saturday morning edition of News Channel 3 Weather Overtime.